Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to design a simple mouse with the help of advanced surfacing tool. I wish you like it. So let's see how to do in SOLIDWORKS with the help of surface tools. Now let's start to create our mouse with the help of surface tools. So let's start. Choose top plane, sketch. Go to sketch and select spline and draw one geometry. Exit. Make this 3 points, origin and 2 end points, horizontal relation. Okay, now select this spline, select this arrow and make vertical, the same another side vertical, the mid one select horizontal. Okay, now it's time to define the dimension. Both the end points should be 50 mm. Now it's time to define arrow length. Hundred and five mm, 130 mm, 115 mm, 10.75 mm the gap, and define the length from origin point 25.75 mm. Okay, now this geometry is fully defined. You can see bottom. Exit and go to surface, and here you can select extruded surface and extrude up to 100 mm. Okay, now this is the one of the body. Now again let's go select front plane. Now do one thing, hide this body. Okay, choose front plane, sketch, normal. Again choose spline. Exit. This is the spline. We created one geometry. Now let's define, select this arrow, horizontal, select one another end horizontal, and select the mid one also horizontal. Now it's time to define. First define both the end. Fifty mm, 1 and 7 mm, and another end 12 mm. Ten point 75 mm, and height the same 25.75 mm. Now select the arrow 45 95, and the last one 30. Now all the geometry is fully defined. Exit. Now select this body, show. Now go to surface and select here trim surface. Now we want to trim this surface, so select here standard, select here trim tool, this is sketch, and it here select remove selection and select not upward bottom, natural. Okay, now see bottom surface we removed, that's it. Now again choose front plane, sketch, normal. Choose here center line. Draw one center line and make sure it is passes through origin. Now let's define this. Forty-five point seven five mm, 46.5 mm. Okay, choose 3-point arc and collect these 2 points. Exit. Now select this vertical line and this is spline and make relation tangent. Okay, comes here again, choose 3-point arc, connect these 2 ends. Exit. And we will make one relation, select this side vertical line and this arc tangent. Okay, now go to surface, select extruded boss and extrude up to 10 mm, but reverse direction. See? Okay, that's it. Now we want to create one plane. Select this plane, show. Select here right plane, go to feature, plane, and in this first arc there is one point. Select this point. See, we selected this first arc point. Okay, now this arrow this created. Select this plane, sketch, normal. Choose here center line. Draw one construction line. Exit. Now see, this line coincide, make sure it is coincide with this. Okay, it is coincide. Appear, select this end point and select this bottom line and make relation pierce. Okay, select normal, choose spline and draw one arc. Exit. It must be coincide with this line. Select this arc, select arrow, upper arrow, and make relation vertical. Normal. It's time to define. And the distance from here to origin point, 23 mm. Okay, now exit from the sketch. Now just hide the plane. Now we can hide the first sketch. Now again choose top plane, sketch, normal, and here we will make one geometry. So again choose spline, draw one similar geometry like first one. First select both the end point and select mid origin point and make one relation horizontal. Now select this one side arrow vertical, the another end vertical, the mid one horizontal. It's time to define. 46.5 mm, 45.75 mm. Okay, now define this arrow, 80 mm, 115 mm, and let's say mid one 95 mm, and select the center distance from origin point 10.75 mm. And define the length 23 mm. Now the geometry is fully defined, so simply exit. Now it's time to create some boundary. Go to surface, choose here boundary surface. First select this end and make it tangent to face. Now second select this edge and keep it normal to profile and go to direction 2. In direction 2 select this upper edge, see, and second create, select this arrow, this geometry we created sketch, and here tangency, it is asking tangency influence, so keep 10, it is quite near. And here select trim by direction 1, trim by direction 2. Now see, this half portion we cut and go down mesh density 3, direction 1, scale 40, 30 density, that's okay. Now see the one side created. This geometry select show. Now again choose boundary surface. Now this time select this edge and this edge and both keep here tangent. Tangent to face both the edges. Now select the same clear. Clear. Select this edge, tangent, tangent to face. The second one, select this bottom and this top one and keep this one 10 and come down and select here trim by direction 1, direction 2. So this half portion trimmed, only this half portion going to work. You can see the density and mesh here and the rest is same. 3 mesh density, 25, 40 scale. Okay. Now select this surface extruded part 1 and hide. See the one end we create. Now here select our plane 1, sketch, normal. First select this inside line and click convert entities. Again select the line, construction geometry, normal, choose spline and draw one spline. Select this spline, select this arrow and make relation horizontal and this relation vertical. Twelve mm, 40 mm. Okay. Now select this spline and this spline, make relation tangent. Okay. Now define this gap. (37.25 mm). Okay. And make relation. Both should be in one position, in one line. Okay. Now see, it is fully defined. Exit. Go to surface and select extruded boss and extrude up to 10 mm. Okay. See. Now we want to create one plane. So select front plane. Plane. And make 15 mm. Okay. Now select this plane. Sketch. Normal. Draw one construction line and select this outer edge of construction line and this outer edge. Make relation pairs. Normal. Select this plane. Normal. Choose spline and connect with this point. Exit. Now here also we want to make one relation. Select this end point and this pairs. Undo. Now delete this relation. Coincident. Now try. Pairs. Okay. Choose 3-point arc. Draw one arc. Select this arc and make construction. And select this arc and outer edge. Make equal relation. Okay. Now select these two arcs. Tangent. Okay. Same here. Select this. Tangent. Now let's define. Fifteen mm, 26 mm, and define the vertical 23 mm. Select. Define the angle 23 degree and again select this arrow and length select 100 mm. Now see, the geometry is fully defined. Let's me check what balance. Select both the end point. Okay, now this geometry is fully defined. You can see here. Now simply exit. That's it. Now hide this plane. Select front plane, sketch, normal. Select here center line. Draw one construction line, one end to another end. Fifty mm, both the end. Okay, now select this outer edge, convert entity, and here also select the outer edge, convert entities. Choose spline, connect with this point, exit, tangent. Tangent. It's time to define (25 mm, 10.75 mm) and vertical distance 37.25 mm. (40 mm). Okay. Now select this arrow and make relation horizontal. Now let's again define 142.5 mm. Now this geometry is fully defined. Exit. Now see, now here we want to create one plane, so go to feature, select plane, select this arrow, this arc, and select this center point, coincide and perpendicular. Okay, now select this plane, sketch, normal, choose this spline. Connect from one end to this end and up to this end. Exit. Select this end point and this previous arc, coincide relation. And here also coincide relation. Horizontal, this one like little, it's time to define, select (82°, 12.5 mm). This gap must be 15 mm by default. 7.5 mm. Okay. Choose spline. Exit. Now select this spline. Construction. Now again select this end of spline. And this coincide. Now select this spline and this is both the spline make relation tangent. Okay. Now define this arrow. (37.57 mm). Okay, this is the our geometry. Select here fully defined sketch, calculate. Okay. Now exit. Now hide this plane. Now select here 3D sketch and select this line, convert entity, choose here center line and draw one vertical line. Exit. Now do one thing, choose trim entity and trim this half line and trim this construction line also. Now exit. Now this our geometry is created, so let's try. Go to surface, fillet boundary. Here choose first this arc and keep it tangent to face. Now second select this and select it normal to profile And the third one, select this line and keep it tangent to face. Now comes down, and here first select our this geometry. This one keeps 75 mm. Now here select this second this geometry. First geometry keep normal to profile and keep 50%. Second none, and here also every geometry 75%. Now see here, okay. Now see this geometry created. Now do one thing, select front plane sketch. Now select this our previous boundary. We created one structure. See this geometry. Select this line. Convert entities. Select normal. Okay. Choose center line. Draw one vertical line here. Draw one vertical line here. Let's define the gap. 25 mm. Okay, choose trim entity and trim this half lines. Trim this outer line also. Only make sure it is 25 mm. Okay. Now exit. Now go to surface. Boundary surface, see this line selected, select this line, clear, only select this 3D sketch, first here select normal to profile and keep 100%, and here select tangent to face, keep 100%. Okay, now see, now select top plane sketch, normal, select here spline, first draw a center line up to here. Choose this spline. This point to this point. Exit. Select this spline. Select this arrow. Make vertical. And this arrow horizontal. Let's define. mm one side. 23 mm another side. Okay. Now delete this construction line. Now go to surface. Exit. Select here trim face. Now select this outer. Here already sketch selected. Remove selection and select this face. This face we want to remove natural. Okay. Now see. Select the full body, little dark color. Now it's looking here. Now here select front plane sketch. Now in front plane we created one sketch previously. Show. Okay, this is sketch. Select here convert entities. Now see, we converted this sketch. Exit. Now select our plane 1. Sketch. Now select this sketch we created. Go to extruded surface, extrude 4. Select this sketch. Convert entity. Now here it is converted. Exit. Now just go to surface. Select here surface boundary. Now see here one sketch selected, normal to profile, and select another sketch, keep normal to profile. Now here select this face, right click selection manager, select here open loop, select group, select one face and select inside. I think better select this command. Select here OK. Choose here tangent and keep 100%. Select both the tangent to faces. Keep 100% and here select 75%. And come down and select here trim by direction 1, trim by direction 2. See, now this is the actual face. I hope you got it. Okay. Now see. Make this face also the similar face. Okay. Now here we will close this open space. So select this surface boundary 4. Okay, here we created this geometry. So select here 3D sketch. Select this geometry. Where is gone? Okay, convert it. Choose trim entity and trim this half line. Now exit. Now go to feature, surface boundary. Here select this end. Select this two geometry. Click here trim both side. First we will select normal to profile. Tangent 100%. Tangent to face 100%. And here keep normal 75%. Select OK. Now see this one face created. Now select 3D sketch, select this face, convert entity, again choose center line and draw one vertical construction line and choose trim entity and delete this extra part and this vertical also exit. Now again go to surface, select here boundary surfaces. Now select here these two faces, make it select this curve, trim by direction 1, tangent, keep none, normal to profile. Okay, now select yes. See, now both the faces selected. Now almost half portion clear. Now here we want to make some cutouts. So go to top and select surface trim. Here we created one structure, one sketch, sketch number 2. Choose front plane, sketch, select sketch number 2, convert entity, normal, offset 0.2 mm, select, see it's going upward direction, okay. Now let's try to trim. Go to surface, select here trim surface, select this face, okay. We forget to add this side, so again edit and select this face also, try to rotate, go back side and inside there is a small edge, maybe you will find, okay, that's it. Now hide this geometry, now choose top plane, sketch, normal, select here spline, and create a spline up to here, again choose one spline, connect both the end, exit, first define one spline, vertical, vertical. Now define this 10.75 mm. Gap from bottom 5.75 mm and this distance from outer line 6.25 mm and this end 1.35 mm. Okay. Select both the points, choose tangent. Select this arrow horizontal and choose this arrow also horizontal. Now it's time to define the length. Hundred and twenty mm, 80 mm. Select one end, 65 mm, and the other end. Okay. Delete this tangent relation. Now let's try. Okay, choose offset. 0.13 mm, select this, choose reverse and select the second one also. Okay. Now go to feature, surface, choose stream entity and select this middle passage. That's it. We selected this mid passage. Okay. Now see, we created the passage, a gap. Now let's try to mirror. Choose your front plane, mirror, select bodies. Select carefully all the bodies. This part and this external part I will not select. Okay. Now see. Surface, knit surface. Now I want to combine those all bodies. Okay, again choose surface knit. Now this time I'll select this faces. Okay. Now we will close this background back face. So choose here one important tool, filled surface. Now here we will select the edge. Select only edge, not surface. Now see, it's going to fill. Okay. Now see the back surface fill. Now select this face, hide. Here also select this face, hide. Hide. This is unnecessary face. Actually it is for reference purpose. Net. Select all the surfaces. Now here we want to make some cutout for ball, screw, choose top plane, sketch, normal, select here, first define the center line. Straight slot. Let's define 3.75 mm, 10 mm, and the distance from one end to last end 10.25 mm. Okay. Now go to surface and choose trim surface. Select this inside face. Okay. Now see, it is trimmed. We make the hole for ball. Mouse scroller, actually not ball, or you can say ball. It's now choose thickness. Upper 0.5, select this face first. See here we selected this face. Okay. See, it's become 0.5 mm thick. Again choose thickness. Now this time select this face. One mm, choose bottom. Okay. Now select this last thickness and define the color red. Okay. Thickness. Surface. Again choose thickness. Point 0.5 and select this bottom body 0.5. Okay. See, now we can see here the thickness is more, so this second thickness we will reduce. Edit, select 0.5. That's it. Now here we want to make some grooves, so select top plane, sketch, normal. First draw a center line, make sure horizontal rectangle, exit. Now select this rectangle and center line and make relation symmetric. Now define the width 0.6 mm, select the length 50 mm, and define the distance from outer edge of mouse to 1 mm. Okay, go to feature, select extruded cut, select reverse direction. Now here bottom, select bodies, select this thickness 3. See only this upper face. Okay, now see here we cut only in thickness 3. Okay. Now select right plane, front plane, sketch, normal, and here we will create a ball. So draw two balls. Now let's define this distance. mm 15.5 mm, outer dia 25 mm, and inner 6 mm. Okay, now select extruded boss. Keep end condition mid plane 6.5 mm. See here. Okay, now here we will do some modification. Mm and select the width, make 6 mm mid plane end condition. Okay, and this slot also we need to edit. See, keep 10.5 mm. Okay, exit. Now let's try fillet. Keep 3 mm, select this surface. Okay, now see, now again choose front plane, sketch, normal, select circle, find out the midpoint of circle. Up to midpoint. Select circle and just above the circle. Point 5 mm and the gap 0.1 mm. Connect both the end points. Okay. Choose center line. Let's define this gap. Mm. Okay. Now go to feature, select revolve. Boss base. Select this line as a axis. Keep 90 degrees and select here at condition mid plane. See. Okay. Now see, we cut some groove. Select here circular pattern, select this cutout, try to select the axis circular face, select more numbers. Okay, 50 numbers equal spacing. Now see, the ball is created. Now choose fillet 0.1 mm. Okay. full surface selected. Close. Now that's it. This is our simple mouse. See. Now save this part. I hope you like it. Please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Don't forget to share and like our videos. Thanks for watching.